Thank you very much. Well, it's a great pleasure to be here. I'm completely humbled by what I've seen so far. I'm sure more is going to come. We're talking about energy. We've got potential kinetic and electromagnetic energy. Yeah, I figured I could invent a new one called inspirational energy. And what's really cool about this energy is it's free. Yeah, and you can generate it endlessly. Yeah, you know, it is possibly, you know, the best thing for the world. It's inspirational energy. And what does it do? It's energy which inspires people to excellence. Yeah, so for me, excellence is about achieving and not about achieved. I figured that if you have an energizer, yeah, and that would tend to be leadership, yeah, not just up there, but there and there, yeah, team members and an opportunity and a challenge, then we can generate some of this inspirational energy. Yeah? And then you can use that inspirational energy. It's key that we've got an energizer who really wanted to get things energized, lots of team members, and opportunity challenge. These are anything which is irregular or incongruous, inconsistent, abnormal, or a deviation. It's something which is not where we want it to be. Yeah? And the whole point is we need to highlight that. Energizing and catalyzing. What does an energizer do? Yeah, this is a leader or a person who can influence. An energizer has to give intensity to the team member, yeah, or the team. It's about being there. It's about all of these things plus more. You've got to be present. Yeah, you've got to be in the factory floor. You've got to be on the field. You've got to be in the call center with those people. Yeah, you've got to take interest in what they do. Yeah, you can't just put up an MBU board and say off you go. Yeah, you've got to take interest. It's a lot of these things, small things happening non-stop all the time. It's got to be consistent. It's the Gemba walk, walking round, seeing people going, looking at the board. You know, if I go and look on the board, everybody's like, oh wow, he's looking at the board. Yeah, yeah. Coaching, challenging, you know. You've got to poke people. Did you get on with that project? Where are we with that one over there? Yeah. Tell me, what, you know, that KPI, do we really need that one on there? Is that, yeah, coaching, you know, asking open questions, challenging people. At the same time as giving intensity, we've got to give focus, yeah? So, vision, mission, values, we all know that one. KPIs and measures, high visibility tools, team meetings, MBU boards, and setting expectations. And the point is that if we give a bit of intensity over here and some focus over there, we might get these two parts to react and make an improvement. And when the improvement is made, then we release inspirational energy. I said the energy is for free. It can even be amplified for free through reward and recognition. Yeah. Reward and recognition doesn't necessarily mean let's give them some money. Yeah. Reward and recognition can start right at the bottom level. It can be also, you know, points or bonus or whatever, but it can also be, hey, thanks, well done. Yeah, I think that's good. An energizer leader, yeah, cannot just give intensity, you know, oh, here I go, yeah, let everybody, let's go out to MBUs, let's go, yeah, energize, fix. No, you can blast people. It can be too much. Yeah, so you've got to be always, as an energizer, checking, looking, listening, sensing, feeling. Am I pushing that pedal too hard? Yeah, yeah. These are skills that an energizer and a manager has to have. How much, when to push harder, when to release, when to look wide, and when to look in. This is the energizer. As we said, energizers need a whole bunch of stuff. They also need the judgment, the sensitivity, and the awareness to balance that focus and intensity. Yeah? We need to be progressive, acting with passion, force, and positive intent. Positive, by the way, doesn't mean to say I have to go around patting everybody on the back of me. Oh, you did good, you did, even when they didn't. Okay, so we've got the intensity coming up here from the energizer. He's judging and making sure he's pushing that energy up and into the team member. With this focus, he's pulling and he's directing, he's channeling the creativity and the capabilities of the team members down to meet the challenge. Bam! And where the two meet, boom, you get byproduct. The byproduct is the improvement, and it releases this inspirational energy. Let's meet the team member. Okay, we have a lot of people in our business. So, not everybody starts as an energizer, but everybody can energize, small or large. We don't all need to be mega energizers, okay? We just need everybody to be a little bit energized. You can never choose your team members right from the beginning. You've got to work with what you've got, yeah? But sooner or later, we've got to figure out if they're going to energize and work well in that position or not, okay? We've got a few team members here. This is an energized one. This is, I'm okay, you know? I come to work, I'm okay. All right, yeah. Oh, I'm having a bad day, I need some inspirational energy, and then we've got this guy over here. Oh, he's sucking in that energy. Yeah, he's eating that energy. There's many different forms of the energy absorber. But generally, it's the person who's really not passionate about what they do. They've got something else in their mind that they're more passionate about. You've got to be really careful about these energy absorbers, that you don't throw all your energy into there. And all these I'm okay guys are saying, yeah, well, I'm still okay because he's over there throwing all his energy into this guy. And this guy, just as I said, you can generate as much energy as you want. This guy can eat as much energy as you can give. You've guessed it, right? Catalyst is the energizer. You don't, like I say, you don't need, 100 energizers in the factory. Just a few good ones, like all you people out there. Yeah. That gives some intensity to the I'm okay guys. I'm okay guy energizes, and then he himself or she can give off enough energy to catalyze and ignite another team member, because it's like, hey, you know, I did this really good thing the other day and it was working, and then, oh yeah, oh no, maybe I could do this. So they all start to energize each other, and the last step is reflect and amplify this energy. If it's put onto the board, and if the board is in the right place, not hidden away, and if you're celebrating the board, all of this stuff, reflecting like the mirrors on the ball, multiplying that energy, because everybody that walks past that can stop and look and get something from it, yeah? And think, yeah, we're actually achieving, you know, maybe in my department I'm having a bad day, but then I walk past and somebody says, oh, yeah, but this is good over here. So it's not all bad everywhere all the time.